Good day, beloved listeners. I welcome you all to another new day. This is the day the Lord has made. We will live and rejoice and be glad in it. I pray today's message will bless you all in Jesus' name. Amen. As children of God, at times we find ourselves facing battles. In the midst of these battles, God will always prove himself. If we call on him, he will prove himself. Seek the Lord at this time of battle. Great men seek the Lord. When you take your problem to the altar of God, with prayer, he will give you victory. God will fight your battles if you put your trust in him. Whatever you are passing through, God is with you. In Isaiah 43 verse 2, it is written, when you pass through the water, I am with you. Through the rivers, it shall not overflow you. When you walk through the fire, thou shalt not be burned. God never fails. There are spiritual battles, there are physical battles. In all, God will give us victory. In Ephesians 6:12, Apostle Paul explained that we are not fighting against flesh and blood. We are actually fighting against powers and forces of evil in the heavenly places. Our fight is not necessarily against human beings. When we talk of spiritual fight, spiritual battle, it could be sickness, it could be disease, it could be affliction, and so on. God has taken over our battles. Hence, on the cross of Calvary, Jesus said, it is finished. Our battles are over in Jesus' name. In 2 Chronicles 20, verse 3, King Jehoshaphat seek the Lord in fasting and prayer. Proclaiming fast all through Judah concerning the enemies. And God answered and said to him in verse 15, be not afraid or dismayed by the reason of this great multitude, for the battle is not yours, but God's. And God went further to tell him, you don't need to fight in this battle. Stand still, and you will see the salvation of the Lord with you. Because he seeks the Lord, God gave him direction to capture the enemies. With just praises and worship, the enemies were captured. Praise the Lord. How many of us today seek the Lord in times of battles? At times, we want to do it our own way. That is why we fail. And when we have problems, at times, we take it to places where there is no help. We carry these problems on our head. When it becomes too heavy, we put it on our shoulder. Why not go to the altar of God and drop them there? Drop them there for him. He knows how to take off our battles. He knows how to take off your battles. Take your problems to the Lord. Leave it there for him. Today I pray we sing a new song over your battles in Jesus' name. God will give you a miracle that will silence your enemies. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Leave it there. Leave it there. Take your problems to the Lord and leave it there. He will surely deliver you when you put your trust in him. Take your problems to the Lord and leave it there. In 1 Samuel 30 verse 8, David seeks the Lord in problems. He asks God, do I pursue and overtake the Amalekites? Will I succeed? God said to him, pursue and overtake, and you will recover all. Praise the Lord. When David was having problems with the Amalekites, there was war. His wives, sons, daughters, they were all captured. They threw them away. He inquired from the Lord, and God answered him, go ahead. In obedience, he became victorious. He recovered all. None was missing in his territory. Our God is a big God. He never fails. is the one that gives us victory. He's the one that gives us success. Praise the Lord. I just thank God for this short message today. We shall know the Lord will bless into our hearts in Jesus' name. God bless you all for listening. This is Anointed Family YouTube. You can hit the subscribe button, click on the notification bell so that you can be notified when new audios are out. Stay safe, stay at home, and God will keep you and your family. In Jesus' wonderful name, amen.